for watching. Good evening tonight. Welcome to GEHS-TV, MSTC Sports. You're watching Olathe Northwest take on our Trailblazers of Gardner-Edgerton, the undefeated Trailblazers, 19-0, number two in the state. I'm Jarius Jones, and I am going to be one of your announcers and play-by-play announcers, and I have the incomparable Mr. Coach Larry Fennell, who will be doing color commentating. Welcome back, Coach.
Good to see you, Doc.
Hey, man, we've got us a great, we have a great game in store for us. Like I said, undefeated this year, 19-0, number two in the state. This is a great baseball team here, Gardner-Edgerton High School. And ladies and gentlemen, you are up for a treat. This is our final game. This is our final competition of the year. We're going to go through some player highlights. The player highlights will focus on our three seniors. Yep. Our three seniors will be the focus. We're going to start off with number nine, Tyler Buttash. Tyler Buttash comes in with one home run, batting an average of .245.
Yeah, and he's also behind the plate, you know, keeping those balls in front of him and, you know, throwing runners out at second base and third base. He's got a live arm out there, and his bat's alive as well. So we're going to need that senior to step up.
Well, we definitely are looking forward to seeing him play. He's a multi-sport athlete. We've had a chance, the privilege of watching him play football and play winter sports, and now see him here in baseball. So we are excited. We're going to look at our next highlight. Our next student is Jake McClure. Jake McClure wearing number 7. He's batting a .400 average and 24 RBIs. You don't get power out of him, but you get quality.
Well, and that's what it counts. You know, it's all about the runs. You know, it doesn't matter if you're hitting home runs, but if you got 24 RBIs and you're batting .400, you are producing runs for your team, and that's what's important.
So we're excited to showcase him, another senior. And our final senior is Ty Wood, wearing number 1. Ty Wood comes in with a .356 batting average, 5 home runs, and 3 RBIs.
And see, we are back at the same thing. And the difference is with Ty, Ty's got 5 home runs and Jake doesn't have any, but he's batting .356. And those RBIs are points. Those are runs scored, and that leads to 19-0.
Well, we are so excited to see these young men who are playing, and we know that this is going to definitely be a great competition for them. And so we're going to look at our starters. Our starters for Gardner-Edgerton, batting in the number 1 spot is going to be center fielder Ty Wood, wearing number 1. The second batter will be Jake McClure, wearing number 7, left field. We also have Hayden Dyer, our shortstop, who will be the third batter. We also have Landon Turner playing right field, Dawson Williams, who's also playing first base. We have Austin Bowie playing third base. As we said, we also have Tyler Buttash playing as catcher, and pitcher will be Mitch Paul. Those right there that's our starting lineup. That's our starting lineup. And so
looks like a good defense right there to me.
Great defense. So we're going to turn it over to the public address announcer as we wait for the announcing of our starters.
Left field, number 2, Carson Reeves. Batting third, playing first base, number 13, Zach Rick. Batting fourth and catching, number 34, Bryce Johnson. Batting fifth and pitching, number 18, Ethan Kemp. Batting sixth, playing third base, number 17, Camden McKernan. Batting seventh, the designated hitter, number 7, Will Mundell. Batting eighth, playing right field, number 9, Stephen Mesa. Batting ninth, playing second base, number 8, Sam Eric. Playing center field for the Ravens, number 6, Zane Wilson. The Ravens are coached by head coach Brett Mesa with assistant coach Stephen Mesa. And now for your Gardner-Edgerton Trailblazers. Batting first, the center fielder, number 1, Ty Wood. Batting second, the left fielder, number 7, Jake McClure. Batting third, playing shortstop, number 4, Hayden Dyer. Batting fourth, playing right field, number 2, Landon Turner. Batting fifth, playing first base, number 21, Dawson Williams. Batting sixth, playing third base, number 16, Austin Bowie. Batting seventh and catching, number 9, Tyler Buttash. Batting eighth, the designated hitter, number 18, Matt McMillian. Batting ninth, playing second base, number 3, Carson Schrack. And pitching, number 33, Mitch Mock. The Trailblazers are coached by head coach Corey Schrack with assistant Ryan Plankenor. Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that all who are able to do so now please rise, remove your caps, and face the United States flag over the right field fence as we play our national anthem. Makes us all the better, faster, stronger, working harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger, more than ever, longer, after, our work is never over, working harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger, more than ever. Out the top of the first for Olathe Northwest.
Getting themselves ready for the...
The shortstop, number 21, Brady
for
Robinson.
For the start of this game, ready for the first pitch. First pitch, we see number 21, Brady Robinson. Shortstop. First pitch is a ball. Mitch Malk is on the top of the hill for the Trailblazers. Nice hit. That's at least good for one base.
Yeah, that's a good solid hit right there. That's a no doubter. You hit that ball on a rope like that.
Now batting
for the Ravens. Brady on
left
first base.
Number 2, Carson Reeves.
Mitch is going to be looking for the guy who's going to take his throw.
Up to bat is number 2, Carson Reeves, left fielder. Batting second in the order. First pitch is a strike. Well, it takes off the jitters. The no-hitter is broken up, so
yes,
now we can focus on getting out.
It's out the way early.
You want to get those 21 outs.
Next goal, three outs.
There we go. One out at a time.
One out at a time.
0-1 is the count after they check the runner. The runner starts to run, and that's a second strike. So... Two called strikes. Carson Reeves. I'm sure he's not going to put it right down the middle. Play, and he tricks him, gets him up high. And so just like that, a strikeout after the first single.
And that's a good way to come back after that.
Sean Mission Northwest. After that,
the first nice baseman, hard 13, line.
Zach Brink.
They roll it up.
So we have Zach Brink for the Ravens. Late the Northwest. A little low. Runner still remains at first base. If you're not outside, it's a pretty cool evening for a mid-May day.
Yeah, it's not too bad as long as you put a heavy sweatshirt on or a hoodie. Or you see some of the moms and grandmothers out here with blankets over.
It's that kind of night. Reminds me of football.
Yes.
That's where we started. We all started this out in football.
We all started in football, and here we are right now. And you know, I guess they said we're already used to this weather, so let's go ahead and keep giving it to them.
Going to keep it going. 2-0 is a count. A nice hit. Looks like it's foul. Just foul. Just beyond that right field line. Had it been fair, it would have been a multiple bagger. So 2-1 is the count to Zach Brink. Robinson's on first. One out. Checks the runner. Once again, a foul ball on the right side. Feel a few raindrops sprinkling in. It's an overcast evening. We've had raindrops for about the last 45 minutes or so that have bounced in. Thankfully, our papers have been salvaged.
So far, so good. It's still early.
It's still early. Third straight foul pitch after starting 2-0. It's still 2-2. Even count. A little breeze here. Nice little hit. And that's going to be a multiple. I think it's a ground rule double. Or
ground rule double,
goes
yes.
Goes over the fence.
Good job, Brink.
That was a pretty hard hit ball right there. Kind of froze the right fielder a little bit with this breeze we have coming in at us out of right field.
Catcher, and number 34.
Kind of froze Bryce a little Johnson. Bit, but. It's going to be tough to catch that ball. He hit that ball very well. So now Mitch just needs to focus in on this batter now and see if we can't get it out.
Bryce Johnson is up to bat, first baseman. Timeout's called. So just one out. Men on second and third, so scoring position. Nice little stinger right to the third baseman. So that's two outs.
Yeah, that's excellent. That's another ball that was hit. You say right on the screws. They are dialed in to Mitch early. So Mitch is going to have to change the combination of pitches up. Him and Tyler are going to have to get on the same page and change these pitches up, change the eye level, the speed. These hitters are off to him right now.
Ethan Kemp is up to bat. Fifth batter of the inning. He's the pitcher. First pitch is a strike.
Yeah, just as we talked about it, he pulled a string on him. And young Kemp, my son played basketball with some Kemps from Olathe Northwest back in the day.
I was about to say, you're familiar with the Olathe Northwest program.
I am familiar with a lot of names.
So a wild pitch brings the runner home. So 21 Robinson scores on an error. And Zach Brink advances to third base. Still one out, so still two outs. 1-1 is the count. First batter gets home. Can we leave the other one on? It's the goal. Pop up. And that's fielded by the right fielder, so that right there is a pop-up. But after one, after the half of one inning, the Ravens are leading 1-0. All right, we're going to look at the line, at the batting lineup for our Trailblazers. First batter will be Ty Wood, center fielder, left fielder Jake McClure will be batting number two, shortstop Hayden Dyer will bat number three. Number four batter will be our pitcher, Landon Turner. The third base will be Austin Bowie. Number five, Tyler Buttash. Our catcher will be batting number six. Dawson Williams will be batting our first baseman, seventh. DH will be Matthew McMillan, number eight. And Carson Schreck will be batting in the ninth position. So that's Mitch Malk, I'm sorry, that will be batting. Mitch Malk is just our pitcher, so we have a DH this time.
McMillan will be the DH, and Mitch will just be concentrating on pitching.
We are through, halfway through one inning. So, Coach, you had, what, one out with men on second and third, and you got away with just one, and that was on an error.
And that's on a wild pitch.
Wild pitch.
You know, all in all, you don't want to see that run come across, but it could have been a lot worse. Could have been worse for you if those other runs would have got a hit and brought them in, and you'd still have a man on base and possible opportunity to get more runs. So, you know, that wild pitch gave him that run, but Mitch was able to get out of that inning with a pop-up.
That's right.
The center field, number one, Ty Wood.
So our goal is to make sure that we can match or improve the run output. We want to at least keep pace, not put more on the board in this inning, this half of the inning. It'll be a seven-inning contest, as it is customary in high school. First pitch is a ball. 1-0 is the count to Ty Wood. Makes contact, but ball is fouled out of play.
Yeah, it looks like the dogs across the street are going to be happy that ball is going to make it over there.
Rover. Rover's got him a toy.
Yeah, my dogs will tear it up real quick.
Ethan Kemp is on the hill for the Ravens as he lines up for his third pitch. And it's a little bit too high. It's a ball. 2-1 is the count. Ty has a pretty good stance there. Ball is up and away. 3-1 is the count. Coach, what do you do here?
Anything close, you have to swing. It's going to be a strike.
Will he tempt him? That's inside. Oh, whoa. Maybe I missed the plate.
Well, I'm a little closer visually than you are, and it was close. We'll see if the umpire stays right there for both pitchers.
That was inside. Yeah, that one wasn't good eye. So that's a walk. First walk of the game for either team.
Now batting for the Blazers. The left fielder, number seven, Jake McClure.
So Jake McClure is up to bat, our left fielder.
And this is another one of our seniors that we spotlighted early on. That 400 average could come into play right now with these 41 RBIs he has.
Batting from the left side. Jake wants to definitely advance the runner. He looks at that pitch, and they call it a strike. It's 0-1 to start the count.
Chuck and I had that discussion. Do you swing at the first pitch, or do you let it go? I'm kind of aggressive. That first pitch might be a strike. Go to swing. We'll adjust later.
That's exactly what he delivered. Nice little crack. As you see nice catch.
Good catch out there.
Nice catch.
Nice catch.
So, McClure puts a good hit on it.
How about it? For Gardner,
good defensive play by the left fielder. On left fielder number 17, Camden McCormick. Up to bat is Hayden Dyer, our shortstop. Still runner on first, Ty Wood. They check him down. Makes it back in time. Pretty good crowd out here for the final game of the regular season. Ball is up high. First pitch, 1-0.
Raven baseball parents travel very well.
There are quite a few Raven parents here.
Yeah, they've always done that when my son was in school at Lake Northwest, and my daughter, the baseball team, is always one of the better sports at the school. So a good following, a good crowd, and a lot of good alumni.
2-0 is the count. Check back. You know, for a scholar athlete, it's got to be a delight to have the family, to have the parents supporting.
Yes.
Being a part of the competition. That's a good strike there. Good pitch. Unable to connect. 2-1 is the count. Another check with the runner. The runner is definitely teasing them. 2-1 is still the count. Checks back. You gotta love it.
You have to love it. The baseball games have a lot of extra chatter. You can hear a little more of the baseball game than football game.
There you go.
You know, basketball game, it just kind of depends on how many fans are in the stands. Baseball, we're in close proximity of the fans.
That's right. 3-1 is the count. That ball was up high near the eyes, so that's a second walk of the inning. Second walk of the game.
Now batting for the Trailblazers.
Men on first
right
and second.
Number two.
Up to bat now, our right fielder, Landon Turner. Batting from the left side. Hasn't given a lot of pitches in play. So that was a five pitch walk. That first pitch is a strike.
You get up there and you want that pitcher to throw strikes. If he's not, don't help him. Don't just swing at pitches just because you want to swing. You got to help yourself and help the team as well. So It's a good eye by Hayden in that last at bat.
Nice. Ball is hit. Foul. It's angling foul. Will they get there? They do get there in time. So excellent job. Excellent defense. The men stay at bay.
Yeah, it seemed like the wind just decided it was going to start blowing out of center field right at that point when he hit the ball. And it helped that left fielder track it down. He came a long ways to catch that ball by the fence and foul play.
Yes, he did. Two men down for this inning. Still two men on base, first and second. Up to bat is number 21, Dawson Williams, the first baseman. 0-1 is the count. You're just joining us, the Ravens leading 1-0 after one half inning. Now 1 2/3 of an inning. We're almost two, yeah. So good eye.
Once again, have a pretty good advantage, and that was a slightly outside, but If he stays there for both pitchers, we're all good.
That's the key.
That is the key.
For both pitchers.
It's going to be bad for both sides. It's going to be good for both sides. Don't pick one or the other.
The fans seem to like the pitch for Olathe Northwest, but we'll see.
Yeah, just a slight disgruntledness.
Yep.
Not a lot. It's still early. We'll see what happens.
Batter called time. Now he's ready. teams have seen two runners and make it on base. That was another close one. It's
in our report that he was consistent.
2-1. I see what you did there, coach.
That's right.
Runners. Oh, that's a nice hit. Well, let's see if they can get up to it.
Air
the
ball
bounces in fair. So we got one home. We've got, oh, he fell. He slipped. So we have one that scored. Number one scored, Ty Wood.
Ty Wood.
And now so, batting for Gardner Edgerton, the third baseman, number 16.
That was Austin. Hayden that slipped.
Ooh.
So that was a hit, a single by Dawson Williams, and an RBI.
Correct.
So tie game. We've evened the score. Number 16 is up to bat, Austin Bowie. Austin Bowie's a pretty tall guy. We see a steal, almost a double steal. So 21, Dawson Williams was able to get a stolen base.
And that just adds pressure to the defense when that runner on first base, that runner on third takes off, and there's always a play in. Sometimes you throw back to the pitcher just to see if you can catch that runner on third base sleeping, and he was not.
Yep.
And now we have two runners on, second and third, in scoring positions. A single is possibly two runs here.
That last pitch was fouled off. So 1-1 is the count. That ball's fouled outside along the left side.
Looks like those dogs are going to have a second ball to play with.
Oh, yeah, either that or the cars that are passing by just beyond that fence.
Yeah, we don't. We're not sponsored by Safe Flight, but if it catches a car, they're going to need Safe Flight. or the dent doctor.
There you go. 1-2 is the count. I don't think they can come in Safe Flight and treat that. Just have to take it all off.
I hope they're listening. I have a PayPal, Venmo, and Cash App.
Here we go. 1-2 is the count. Ball foul back against the backstop. So we replay that. 1-2 is the count.
Pretty good battle going on right here. Austin is not letting anything go by that's close, and he's fouling them off. And you know, sometimes you kind of foul them off as much as you can until the pitcher makes a mistake or
there we go.
You make a mistake.
I got to admit, we've got some great camera work here.
Oh, yes.
STC Sports is doing a phenomenal job, led by Todd Henderson and his crew and all of our individuals that are mapping. Larry, Coach, and I, we get a chance to have the sweet spot, get a chance to sit down.
That's right.
And call the game as we see it, but there's so many people behind the scenes. We'll talk about that later. Oh, a nice crack at it. It looks like it's going to be caught by the left fielder. And he catches it out of play. So after one full inning, the game is tied between the Ravens and our Trailblazers. As we see that, great fortune of one base hit in that inning.
Stop right there.
What?
Here, eat a Snickers. You always lose your edge when you're hungry.
Better?
Better. Yo, I said, give me the track, I'm finna snap. You know, timid, I ain't that. Guess your memory got snatched and you forgot that you can't rap. Yeah, you need to get some money, you look broken. You couldn't catch no water.
You're not you when you're hungry.
I ain't knowing how I'm trash, you gotta tell me.
Snickers.
What you mean. It's more holes in your.
The score is one at the end of one full inning. The score is 1-1. So we're now at the top of the second inning and beginning the this inning will be batter Camden McCurman. The third baseman following McCurman will be Will Mundell, DH, and then Stephen Mesa, right fielder, will be batting. Second pitch was low. So we have Mitch Malk at the top of the hill again to start this second inning. And that's a called strike.
Still a little filling out process by the pitcher and the hitters. Still early in the game. And cat and mouse game continues.
Ball is hit right down second base, right through the second baseline between that and the shortstop. So that's a nice solid single by Camden.
Now batting for Olathe Northwest, the designated hitter, number 7, Will Mundell.
That's the third hit of the game for the Ravens. Will Mundell is up to bat. Designated hitter as he tries to bunt it. Bunts it foul.
Good idea. Try to manufacture some runs, get the runner in scoring position and lay down that bunt. Chuck and I talk about this turf all the time. This turf is soft. So the ball's not gonna, on the bunt, it's not gonna roll as far as it would if it were on dirt.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not as unpredictable on the turf as it would be on the dirt.
We never had an opportunity to come out to the complex. It's a beautiful complex, the turf,
yes.
Turf field, softball and baseball field, as long as well as the soccer,
yes,
and
sir.
The football.
Yes.
This is definitely a top-notch complex for any school.
Yes. We've had events where you had varsity men's and women's going at the same time, softball, baseball, JV games on the other fields, opposite side, men's and women, soccer game, and a track meet.
Definitely.
It was a surprise when I got here that day and turned that corner and said, oh, I got to park on the other side of the school.
There you go.
It's a long walk for an old guy like myself.
Not old, coach.
Well,
season.
Season. Well, I'll go with that.
A nice high hit. Uh-oh. Ball was dropped with out. Force out. It looked as though it was going to be a fly out.
Now batting for Northwest.
Yeah.
The right fielder. Number 9.
Conversation.
We can say fielder's choice on that one.
Yes, we can. The result is still the same.
First pitch is one a ball. Still have McCurman on first base. Now, I would have thought that the man on first would have been out. Both of them were there together. Force out because it was not a catch, but they kept the lead runner there. I'll have to do our rules check.
Well, I'm not quite sure exactly what happened, but I believe the umpire said that.
Did they call it a caught? A catch? And that one's out, so we have a double play.
Now we have it.
Wow, caught up. The center fielder caught that, and they tagged out the runner. So, hey, at the end of 1.5, it's still a tied ball game.
What will do it? What will turn today's questions into tomorrow's answers that unlocks the mystery of rare childhood diseases? Love will, because love has no limits. And at Children's Mercy, neither do we. With leading researchers working to find the next advancement that will change outcomes, change lives, and change the world. Children's Mercy. Love will.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Adam Winters, the Kansas Highway Patrol. The Kansas Highway Patrol public resource officers across the great state of Kansas have a message for you.
3 out of every 4 car seats are installed incorrectly. Please read your owner's manual and vehicle manual to learn how to install your car seat correctly.
When driving on Kansas highways and you see a trooper in a safety vest and you see the orange cones, you're in a construction zone. Please remember, slow down, don't drive distracted, and move over. It's Kansas law.
Now that you've seen us, make sure you see us and all other first responders and road workers. Move over.
The inning, the second inning is Tyler Buttab, our center. After him will be our DH, Matthew McMillan, and then Carson Schreck, second baseman, will follow. So we have Tyler.
Tyler's another one of those players that we highlighted, a senior, a catcher behind the plate, knocking down those balls, and let's see if we can't keep that average up.
First pitch was a strike. Oh, that one was near the head. He ducked. So 1-1 is the count. I don't think it would feel good taking that one on the head.
Well, we call that a breaking ball. That's a pitch you can just kind of lean into, go ahead and take. Fastball, you may want to get out of the way, but a breaking ball, you don't necessarily have to move. It won't hurt long.
There we go, 2-1. 2-1 is the count.
That's what I was taught when I was a kid. Don't get out of the way. It's not going to hurt.
Until it hurts you.
Yeah, until it hurts. That's right.
Nice hit. That one is right. That's solid. That's a good base hit.
It's a solid base hit right there, going to the opposite field, the right field. And Tyler's on. And
next up for the Blazers, the designated hitter, number 18, Matt McMillan.
So that's just the second hit of the ball game. If you remember, we started out the game with a couple of walks. First 2 of 3 batters walked, one scored. So now we have up to bat our DH, Matthew McMillan. He tries to shows the bunt, and he's out. He got him on the head. That was a good defense there.
Yeah, that's a case of the turf actually slowing you down. If that was dirt, he would have slid in there with a much faster pace. But that turf, he kind of got hung up a little bit. So hit the brakes on him.
And there goes a strike. 1-1 is a count. I like the riskiness of that play. Even though he didn't wind up the way the good guys wanted it, it was oh so close to. Yeah, that's a nice pitch there.
Yeah, you want to keep pressure on the other team. Is, you know, if you have a runner that's, you know, fast enough to make it down there, you select a pitch and let him go.
And it's another strike. Strikes him out. That's the first strikeout of the game.
That is the first strikeout.
The second baseman, number 3, Carson
Pitcher. Kemp records his first strikeout. And then Carson Schreck. He's up to bat with 2 men out. And that sound was brought to you by MSTC Sports.
That's right. All we need is a little caption with a pow on the top of it.
The old Batman television series. 1-0 is the count. Hey, baseball can be a slow game. You got to comment almost on anything.
Hey, we got to keep the patrons entertained.
There we go.
You just don't want to give them balls and strikes. You got to give them some other things to think about.
2-0 is the count.
Some material they can use on a later date.
There you go. And when you're this close to the backstop, I'm not going to lie, I did jump.
I did not.
Oh, that's a nice little sound. I know you didn't. You're used to getting balls hitting the top of your head.
I am.
So here we go. It's recorded out a line out there. So at the end of 2, the game is still tied. We'll be back right here on MSTC Sports GEHS TV.
Price Chopper, we know we're not the only grocery game in town. That's why we're always chopping prices. We're passing along the savings on our fresh cut meat. We're fueling your squad with affordable party trays and meals to go. And scoring you great low prices on all your game day favorites. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows Price Chopper.
We're at the movies and we need to silence our phone. Who knows where that button is?
I don't have silent.
Everyone does, right up here.
It happens to all of us. We buy a new home and we turn into our parents. What I do is help new homeowners overcome this.
Was that an adjustable spanner? Good choice, Steve.
Okay, don't forget, you're not assisting him. You hired him. You have nowhere to sit. You have too many. Who else reads books about submarines?
My dad.
Yeah.
Oh, those are...
Progressive can't protect you from becoming your parents, but we can protect your home and auto when you bundle with us.
Look at that.
And welcome back. This is the top of the third inning. We've had three hits from the Ravens and two hits from our Trailblazers, but the score is 1-1.
1-1.
We've had an error. Top of the inning, even though it's not recorded, although they may not call it the wild pitch, but it did score a run.
It was a wild pitch for sure.
So
yeah. Any pitch that gets away from the catcher that rolls, I don't know about, I think it's 2 feet away, is can be considered a wild pitch.
And we're at the bottom of the order. Sam Eric, final batter for the Ravens. We've already gone through once for the Trailblazers. First pitch is a ball, 1-0. Mitch is still at the top of the hill. Second pitch is a ball. This kind of reminds me of how we started off this last half of the inning, or the last inning.
He's making a conscious effort to keep the ball down, and by doing that, he's kind of tugging the ball a little bit.
That's a third pitch.
As you can see right there, it's maybe the ball has a little moisture on it. It's not raining here, but it's just... It's not a mist. Mm-hmm. It's just a little spit here and there, a little drop here and there. And, for a pitcher, that's enough to get a little moisture on that ball, and just holding on to it a little too long. So he's kind of tugging at the ball and dropped it down in the dirt.
3-0's a count. It's definitely a hitter's count. That's a strike. 3-1's the count. And makes connection. Looks like our right fielder may be able to pull that one down. The wind is blowing a little bit, but not too much. So that's the first out recorded of this inning.
Now batting for Olathe Northwest.
The batting now is Brady 21, Robinson.
Brady Robinson.
Our shortstop.
Doc, as we sit here, you can feel the wind coming in from left field on us, but the flag out at center field is blowing right to left.
Yep.
So the wind's kind of swirling as the right fielder had to make some different moves to get that ball. So it must be doing something a little different out there in right field than what we see on that flag and fill up here.
Yeah, that's across the street, just beyond the fence.
Mm-hmm.
I see exactly what you're talking about. 1-1 is the count. Brady Robinson had a single in his first at bat to start the game. 2-1 is the count. See the flags blowing in the wind.
Right now, they're blowing right towards us now. So,
right there on that right field foul pole line. Oh, that was pretty high up. Is that gonna go the distance?
Yeah, it's getting juiced.
It bounces over. Another ground rule double. He's 2-for-2. That had some distance there near the, the left center field fence?
Left center field, one bounce on the track and over the top of it. So that's the second time Brady has squared up that ball. So two bats and two square ups. He hit that one pretty good. If that wind wasn't blowing in, it might have had a chance to sneak out of here.
Just hit the base of that fence. First pitch is a strike. Number 2, Carson Reeves. So one out, one man on base, second base.
That could be an effective pitch if Mitch can consistently throw that pitch and control it. That's a nice change-up pitch right there.
contemplates.
It's just I know you're there.
Yeah.
I didn't intend on throwing, but I just need to let you know I know you're there.
Being a right-handed pitcher is kind of tough to angle it and throw it out, make that turn.
Yeah, that turn that way, it's, because you have to step off that rubber, it makes it a tougher turn. So, seen some pitchers just step straight off of it and throw it back, but that's a bad arm angle that can cause other problems. So it's better to kind of step off and spin.
When that spin happens like there, it makes me think of, I can't remember what movie it is, but watch out there now. That uncle that comes by.
That uncle.
Makes that twirl. Yeah, watch out there now.
There's always that one uncle.
0-2 is the count.
And it's always his song.
Don't worry about it. Just a bunch of movement. That's all. Come on. Now you catch
it. Focus on the batter. Lee Mitch is all in.
There you go.
Whoa. Just up a little bit high.
We will report that it was a little inside.
Well, inside, okay.
Little inside. I won't say high. It's letter high. That's a strike, but it was a little inside.
1-2 is the count. You want to get this out so that way runner in scoring position. Focus on the next batter. That's a pop-up, infield pop-up. Who has it? Third baseman records that. So second out of the inning. Pop up.
Now batting for Olathe Northwest.
Now we have Zach Brink, our first baseman, batting.
The first baseman, number 13, Zach Brink.
Coach is coming out to the mound. Check. Will this be a pitching change or?
This is just going to be a conversation to kind of make sure everything is okay with Mitch.
Yeah.
Pitch count is high for the third inning, so we'll see what happens.
So we.
And this is just a way to coach make sure everybody's on the same page and settle Nick down. Settle. Coach has gone out and settled everything down, and Mitch is back on the rubber and bring steps back in, and here we go.
Account.
You know, the batter will call timeout. They don't like, batters don't like to stand in there very long. They like to get in and get set. Throw me the ball so I can swing. Don't make me stand here and look at you.
It's all about the rhythm.
It's the rhythm. Baseball's all about the rhythm.
Two men out. And that's a strike. Called strike. 1-1 is the count.
Paying a lot of attention to the runner on second base, so they're trying to hold him in there, but a left-handed batter allows that shortstop to kind of do that a little bit.
Right field line, first base line. That brings home a run. So nice little RBI. Robinson scores. He's the second. This is his second time scoring.
That would be his.
Now batting for the
Ravens. Time.
The catcher, number 34, Bryce Johnson.
That was a nice RBI.
It was just off of the glove. Johnson made a diving attempt, and it was just off of his glove. He catches that. He gets up and runs to the bag and no runs scored.
So 1-0 is the count. His first at bat for Brink. I'm sorry, for Johnson. Was a line out to the third baseman.
Hard hit ball. Squared it up. Third baseman was just in the right spot.
1-1 is the count. He's kind of low to the ground, but he's got some good power, and he put some ding on that.
Does generate a nice swing.
Very much so.
Yes. Low center of gravity. Trunk, base, swing, timing. That's it all right now. Pull that ball down. Foul like that, he's all over Mitch's fastball, that's for sure.
1-2 is the count. Ball goes into the dirt. That's a ball.
That's a good thought. Mitch needs to change something up and throw the breaking ball right into the dirt to see if he can give him this lunge out at one.
2-2 is the count. Yep. Remains 2-2.
Man, he's got him out ahead. That's the second one he's fouled over. Almost into the dugout. Everybody better pay attention over there.
Heads up.
He's coming around pretty quick.
Ooh. Tempting.
We will continue to report that the umpire is consistent. He's a little outside.
Full count, 3-2.
Runners will be moving. Mitch knows that. That's why he throws the ball over first base. 3-2 Golden count, two outs. The runner wants to get an extra step. Single can become a triple instead of just a one base. So,
I think that's definitely what they're looking for. Full count, two outs. What do you have to lose?
Yeah, you want to make sure you get this guy out at the plate.
Foul ball.
Hits a screwball. Weather like this, that doesn't feel very well. The ball off the end of the bat like that. Shockwaves. Shockwaves.
Can Mitch shake off the run and keep it just a one-run deficit? Continues to hold the runner at bay. That ball's popped up and back. Out of play.
Yeah, well, these foul balls and the hits that are hitting, Mitch's pitch count is starting to creep up.
Mm-hmm.
Start thinking about that, especially late in the season, you know.
It's a nice hit ball. Right there to the center fielder, and so at the end of two and a half, the score is 2-1. Well, graduation is upon us. Graduation will be held May the 22nd. You can find it right here on GEHS TV at 10 a.m. 10 a.m. is the start of graduation, is what's confirmed. It will get confirmation at 8 a.m. on that particular day based on the weather. If there is rain or inclement weather, we'll move it to 12 noon. If it continues to rain in every two-hour increments, from there they'll make a decision on whether or not if the graduation will be held on that day or at that time. So you want to make sure that you're aware of all of that information, and we'll continue to mention. Hey, man, I had a daughter that graduated last year and felt like, you know, she was robbed of the opportunity because they really didn't have the full graduation. And
yeah,
so your heart goes out to those scholars, but you're glad to see that graduations are happening.
Yes.
People are utilizing the outdoors.
Yes.
The outdoors options.
Number one. Todd
Wood. Outdoor graduations are good.
Outside.
two and a one. You see right there, the pitcher is able to go in and tag the base.
Now batting for the Blazers, the left fielder, number seven.
That was Ty
Jake
Wood.
McDool.
I know. Jake McClure is now up to bat. We're at the top of the second batter in our order. In the second round of batting. Here in the top, bottom of the third inning. But they say not today.
So very good hit, right back up the middle.
The shortstop, number four, Peter Dyer.
All right, we want to say hello to the family of our coach in Ogallala, Nebraska. He sends a happy Mother's Day to his mother, Norma. Happy belated Mother's Day. Happy belated Mother's Day. It's always special.
Always special. Happy Mother's Day, Norma.
He has coach's privilege.
That's right. That's right. We have to do what the coach says. He wants a shout-out, we give it to him.
Now, I can't tell you where Ogallala, Nebraska is, but I can tell you this. It's in Nebraska.
Well, I only know where Plasmith is at, so I don't know where Ogallala is. I'm going to have to look that up.
1-0 is the count. Nice shot, but that looks like it's going to be catchable by the right fielder. So, two men out.
Jake's second pop up.
For the Trailblazers. The right fielder. Number two, Landon Turner.
Coach's must season.
All right.
So, Miss Norma, thank you for watching GEHS TV. MSTC Sports to see your Trailblazers play. They've had a wonderful season. Undefeated.
Yes, they have.
Second in the state. I'm sorry, we're not undefeated. That's what the 14-3 is the record.
Well, undefeated sounds a lot better.
14-3 is a record, but still ranked number two in the state.
That's right.
Oh, that's almost lower pitch.
Yeah. Counterpart's been here a lot.
Yes.
So he would have known that information.
Yeah, he would have known that. He would have known that.
He's out suntanning in Hawaii. So, you know, he sent me a couple pictures and a message, and I sent him some hate grams back.
That's not right.
Don't send me no stuff that I'm not available to do. Especially if it's a beach involved.
Oh, boy. About right now, I could use some beach weather because it's freezing. It's cold out here.
It is a little chilly out here. I saw a couple planes fly by earlier. New Century's not far from us, and Chuck's son he's gotten his pilot's license, and so now he's flying around Hawaii sending me pictures. And
very nice.
And I send him hate mail, too. Don't send me things that I can't do.
And you know you got to be nice. That should be a cousin there, buddy.
Well, so. He is bigger than I, but I am older, but he is bigger than I. So.
There we go.
He's a Ranger, so he knows some things that I probably don't know. So
there we go.
I will try to be nice to him.
2-1 is the count. Man on second. Two out. Nice pitch there. 2-2 is the count.
It was a good pitch. Low inside. Righty to a lefty coming across.
And that was brought to you by the third base cameraman, GEATV.
Yes. It was a whack. It wasn't a pop. That was a whack.
It's a whack.
Yeah, it's a whack.
Even count, 2-2.
Just put the caption up, whack. If it was glass, it would be shattered.
Yes, it would have been. Batting 458 is Landon Turner.
I'm just going to need you to stop moving.
Right. needs a net when you've got galvanized fencing? And that's a strikeout there. Strikeout. So that ends the third inning after three. The score is 2-1 in favor of the Latham Northwest Ravens. We'll be back after this timeout. You're watching GEHS-TV, MSTC Sports.
Your whole team can see your upper thigh. Pour that smooth roast and aim that camera up high.
The best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Adam Winters, the Kansas Highway Patrol. The Kansas Highway Patrol public resource officers across the great state of Kansas have a message for you.
3 out of every 4 car seats are installed incorrectly. Please read your owner's manual and vehicle manual to learn how to install your car seat correctly.
When driving on Kansas highways and you see a trooper in a safety vest and you see the orange cones, you're in a construction zone. Please remember, slow down, don't drive distracted, and move over. It's Kansas law.
Now that you've seen us, make sure you see us and all other first responders and road workers. Move over.
And welcome back to the start of our fourth inning. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Dylan Butash, wearing number 6. We'll be pitching to the pitcher of the Ravens, number 18, Ethan Kemp.
That'd have been a good change with the pitcher right there.
One into the alley, gets that ball with one hand, the bare hand, brings it back in. So a double to start the inning. Now Ethan Kemp starts it off with the double.
The third baseman, number 17.
This is the third inning where we've had the inning started off with the hit.
Yeah, that was a good shot. It was.
He found that alley right there.
Found that alley. It was.
Love the defensive play of a center fielder. Picked it up with his bare hand.
The wind picked up now, but when he hit that ball, there was no wind. Heads up.
Feet up.
Hot potato.
You know, he almost took out the, he almost took out his colleague on deck.
We call that friendly fire. Pay attention. Eyes up.
Here we go. After one pitch, 0-1 is the count. No outs. Man on second base, Dylan Butash is softball. One and one is the count. We're at the top of the fourth. I know it says bottom of the fourth in the graphic, but we're at the top of the fourth. Nice hit. Right up beyond second base. That's going to bring home one run. Hold the batter to first base. So that's the third run of the game. You see that pitch right up above.
He just took that pitch where it was pitched and went straight back up the middle. So Kemp was running. It's a very strong throw from center field out there. Kemp was a half a step slow. We might have had a play at the plate. Yeah, it looks like the Ravens came in today intent on hitting the ball, and they are getting some good swings in.
They definitely are. And now that they've got into the bullpen, so to speak.
Yes.
First two batters have taken advantage of it.
Up pitch to bat. Same result.
Will Mundell is up to bat. 1-2 is the count. That was a ball. Ball is in play. He slides. They
good
call him
play.
Out.
Good play.
Call him out.
The coach is going to appeal it, but from my advantage sitting there, I could see that the glove was there before
risky
the bag
play.
Was there. So the question would be, did he have the ball in the glove or did he have the ball in his hand? We're going to take a look at that and see how that works.
They don't get a chance to see our replay.
There we go. Takes off running and a slide and...
Now batting for Lake Northwest.
Bang, bang.
The right fielder.
Let's call it out.
Bang, bang.
Stephen Mason.
He called it out and they can't come over here and ask us for the replay. We are not authorized to do that.
I saw what I saw. They saw what they saw.
That's right.
It's out. That was his second fielder's choice out. As many at bats. Up to bat now is Stephen Mesa, our right fielder, who ended the inning, his first at bat, fly out with a double play. Oh, that's a nice high hit. Center fielder gets that one. So two outs. Keeps the second baseman there at play. So we're going to watch this Riccio. I think we'll see if they
second baseman
slow it right up as we see here this play. And that's a rare thing that he would take that run and slide. And he gets there.
He just got there.
He got there.
He got there.
Excellent officiating.
Yes.
And great camera work from MSTC Sports.
That's right. That's right. From my advantage, it looked like he was out there. I saw the same thing from this. This angle that where I'm sitting at, I can see him slide, that glove hitting and the foot came down. So, yeah.
Changes the dimension of this inning. Want to know his account. Two and O is the count. Game of inches.
Game of inches. That is going to be important for the Blazers to get out of this inning with no more damage done. You know, down 3-1 and on the top of the fourth inning. So we'll see what happens.
So far, 3-0 is the count. We got a trivia question. No one got it the last time. So they'll let us know here momentarily, maybe between innings, the trivia question. Remember, you have Facebook. /MSTC Sports/ That's what you can access to enter the answer. That's a pitch. Now it's a full count. Started out 3-0. Full count. Two outs. Man on second base. Where are you pitching, coach, if you're Dylan?
Strike.
And that's a strike. Chance for a pop-up play. And the right fielder is able
good.
To come in and catch
he
that.
Him
so
up just in time.
That ends the inning with no more damage. One run across the base, across the plate. At the end of 3.5, the score is 3-1 in favor of Olathe Northwest. So here is the trivia question, ladies and gentlemen. For a generation of young men and women in USD 231, their first memory of the interscholastic athletes involved the 2005 GEHS Hall of Fame inductee. He coached for 29 years at the junior high and had been associated with GEHS athletics for 57 years upon retirement. Who is that great legend? It wasn't you. You haven't been on this earth yet quite 57.
No, I have not.
You got a 7-year start on me, so it wasn't me, buddy. There we go. So who is it? Who is that great legend? You all saw the information there. Go to Facebook/MSTC Sports to enter your answer. I know there is a Trailblazer aficionado who knows the history, the everything about GEHS Sports. And so
there's always at least one.
Come on. There's at least one.
There's always at least one.
So up to pitch is Colton Baumgart, number 14. He's going to be pitching for the Ravens. Pitching change. Pitcher Ethan Kemp did an excellent job to start out. He moves out to play one of the field positions.
Looks like he might be going out to roam center field. Yeah, that's exactly where he's going. Just like his older brothers, tall and slender.
That's right.
I'm looking around to see if mom and dad were here. My son played with his older brothers from J junior high school and high school for a few years, and so I would see them all the time in basketball season.
Up to bat is 21, Dawson Williams. First pitch. Gets a little metal on that ball.
Nice play by the young man in the dugout.
Dawson Williams scored the only run of the game, where he collected an RBI for the only run of the game.
That's right.
With that single. That was a single in the first inning. Starts out this at bat, 0-2. Ball is away. Low and away. One and two is the count. Nice hit.
Yes,
it's right there towards center field.
Get down for a base hit right in front of the right fielder.
Now batting for the Blazers, third baseman.
Can't mount a comeback unless you have runners on base.
Austin Bowie is up to bat, batting from the left side of the plate.
Dawson's second single of the day.
First at bat. Fly out. Let's see if this one seems to be the same variety. Great defense there. Another fly out for Austin Bowie. First out of the inning.
The Gardner Edgerton. The catcher. Number nine.
Number nine, Tyler Butash. Is up to bat. The catcher.
Here's a senior coming up in a position to advance these runners. So we know he can hit. Has the average to prove it. Let's go ahead and get one and move these runners around.
First at bat was a single. That was up high. And he got caught stealing the base, trying to steal the base.
He did. Turf monster got him, slowed him up. nobody saw it, but I saw the little hand come up and just kind of grab him, slow him down. And
oh, he thought about that. It just looked too easy.
Took the tag off the head.
Yeah,
he did. Guess they could say he was smart about it.
He did. Well, I'm glad he realized he wasn't playing golf, because that was pretty low.
That was pretty low.
Another one is low. It's 3-0 is the count.
In this situation, I'm down a couple runs with a runner on. I'm swing away. Good pitch, swing away.
See a nice alley right there between center field and left field. Three and one's a count. Holding the runner at bay.
Pitcher's going to ask his first baseman to help him out. Give me the ball back, man. Don't make me bend down and waste energy.
And that's a called strike. So a full count after being up 3-0. Or if you're the pitcher down 3-0, it's a full count.
The pitcher's gotten back into this count, and Tash is going to have to do. He's got to be on his toes.
Yeah. And that's a walk. Six pitch walk.
I will say he's consistent.
The designated hitter, number 18, Matt McMillian.
That was a little outside. Catcher wanted to get a good frame, but it was just a little bit outside. Now we have runners on first and second with one out. Ducks on the pond. We need to get them in.
First pitch is a strike. 0-1, two men on base, one out. Ball hit down the third field line, just foul.
Foul ball.
0-2 is the count. You want to avoid the double play.
You do want to avoid the double play. It makes it, it's a harder double play unless you hit it directly to the bag at third base from the catch, step, throw. It's a long throw across the diamond. It's done quite often. You practice it all the time. But it is it's a considerable amount of things you have to think about at that time. Footwork, catch the ball first, footwork. Step on the bag so that you're not running across the bag, but you're stepping on the bag to push off the bag to throw to help the ball. So a lot of things to think about at that time.
Matthew McMillan gets it up towards second base. It's an error or an overthrow. They were unable to get second base out, unable to get first base out, and we get one run. So no outs there.
And that's exactly what you need. That's exactly what you need right there. So
21 gets the
now
score
for the Trailblazers. The second baseman, number three,
as we see here,
Carson Schrack.
Unable to tag and unable to make the connection for first base, so everybody's safe, one out. That was an RBI.
Yeah, that ball was hit just slow enough to make it a tough throw for the second baseman. That's what you were thinking about. You get that extra run in there now, and a base hit potentially scores two runs at this point. So, you're not only thinking about tying the game, but you're thinking about taking the lead as well.
So take out that force out at second base.
Exactly.
Once again.
He's just staying alive now. He's just
getting the batter, the pitching count up.
Yeah, pitcher staying away from him outside, and he's just slapping at it, fouling it off. You're just hoping at this point that the pitcher makes a mistake. And you get a good solid hit now that the right side of the field is open with no runners over there. You want to hit on that side.
And that's up. Out of play. Near the stands. No one was hurt.
No one was hurt. Grandma was okay. Little brother, little sister did not run into the stands. All is well. And we'll say that the camera is doing just fine as well. So we're good.
We're in great shape.
We're in great shape.
It's a lot of pitches this at bat. Still just a 1-2 count.
And
foul the ball.
Good idea.
That's what runners were ready.
The pitcher's trying to prevent. He's trying to keep that ball outside so this lefty can't pull that ball down the line and get a guaranteed run. Or, first baseman tries to make a play at home plate, overthrows it, and you may get two runs. So, pitcher's trying to stay outside. Batter's trying to hit the ball down right field, get that runner in. So, cat and mouse game continues. He is not going to be happy with that one. He knows it.
The center fielder.
Sometimes as a batter, you get into that mode of swing, and the pitcher gives you something you're not ready for, but you swing because you're in swing mode.
Yeah.
So.
That's all right. He'll get it the next time.
He's good at bat, though.
That was a great at bat.
That was a great at bat.
A lot of pitches. We're at the top of the batting order now with Ty Wood.
Look out, catcher.
Ty Wood lined out the last time at bat. Scored the first time after a walk in the first inning.
Looks like the catcher took a little action on that one. Umpire's going to give him a little time to let that stinger go away.
Trying to get the runner home. See what Wood can do. That's a ball. So 1-1 is the count.
Same position. Pitcher does not want that ball to clear that right field anywhere. That's two runs automatic.
Ball is a little low. Just the pitcher and the batter right now. Ball is up high. 3-1 is the count.
So now here's our situation again. 3-1. Runners at second and third. Does the coach say swing away, or does he say wait for a good pitch?
Ball is hit back. Full count.
Go Colton, win it, kid.
Full count, two outs. Runners at second and third. They will. Thinking about moving. Open base. They have to be careful, though. Don't go too far.
And the pitch. Ball is there, and they're going to be able to tag him out. And he's out. So no more damage done. Only one run across the base.
And our score after four complete.
At the end of four innings, the score is 3-2 in favor of the Northwest Ravens of Olathe. We'll be back after this timeout. You're watching GEHS-TV, MSTC Sports.
You may not hear it at first, but it's there. Echoing against limestone, drifting through the grove. You can feel it running deep beneath all that we are and do. More than a show of spirit, it's a source of energy. You can see it power leaders, fuel innovators, push dreamers into motion. On this summit, callings converge. Voices unify into a chorus, one that sounds out for good, for greatness. Our chant. Rising.
And welcome back. This is the start of the fifth inning. At the end of four frames, the Olathe Northwest Ravens lead 3-2 against our Trailblazers. We were able to get one back and have threatening. We had men at second and third with one out. We're unable to get the run, the other run home, but you have faith that if we can continue to hold them at bay, we'll get that run back and then some.
Yeah, some good pitching and good fielding. And let's see if we can get a 1-2-3 inning out of here and get back in and swing those bats.
Ball fouled out of play. 0-2 is the count. Dylan Boutash is on the hill. That third pitch is a ball. Some wanted it as a strike, but
if there was a left-handed batter up, they would have gotten hit. Might have looked close to someone else, but we got a good advantage point.
Ball is low, so even count, 2-2. On deck is number two, Carson Reeves. That ball goes through the glove of the third baseman. It's number 18, Ethan Kemp.
Yeah, that was a hard hit shot right there. And, third baseman was looking to get his footwork together and scoop and throw and just over the top of him.
So we're at the, Brady is the first batter of the game, the top of the order. Number two, batting second, Carson Reeves. And stolen base attempt, he's safe. So just like that, man in scoring position.
Yeah, Northwest is keeping the pressure on them, but keeping runners in scoring position and tightens your defense up a little bit, tightens the pitcher up when you know somebody's out there that can score and hit. So yeah, it's good coaching right there. Keep the pressure up.
Sure, Dylan is thinking. He started out that inning 1-1 and could have had it out. We have a pop-up here. It's a great play there. Redeem itself. That's his second pop out, Carson Reeves. So one out, man on second. Up to bat, number 13, Zach Brink, our first baseman. Zach's last time out was a single and an RBI. Man in scoring position. Up high a little bit.
Oh,
pitch up high.
Watch the throwback to two. Go, B.
Another pitch up high. That's 3-0 is the count.
Batter got lucky on that one. He was requesting time out, but the umpire said, yeah, it's too late.
So
could have been a strike. It could have handcuffed him.
And that's a strike. The strike. Full count. 3-2 is the count. Dylan would love to be able to get a strikeout here.
Yeah, it would be awesome if you get a strikeout right here and keep that runner there and make it two outs. That kind of changes your thinking at that point.
Ooh.
That's out.
So that's a walk.
Now batting for Lake Northwest. The catcher, number 34, Bryce Johnson.
Number 34, the catcher, Bryce Johnson, is up to bat. He's lined out the first two times. Men on base, first and second. One out. Can we get a double play? First pitch is a ball. Ball was low.
Yeah, it looked like he was trying to aim that ball instead of just throwing it. You see those runners are in his head right now. And just like to see him settle a little bit. And
ball was hit just beyond second base, first baseline. They're able to hold off. Runners, good defensive play. Heads up. No score, but that was a single, solid single by Bryce Johnson.
For Life of Northwest, number 18.
Rounded the base. Brady Robinson thought about it, but wisely slowed up.
Now we have runners on every base. Force out at home.
Courtesy runner at first base, 19, Jackson Powell.
They have Ethan Kemp. Jackson Powell is on first base running.
Running for Johnson.
That's going to be a fly out. Sacrifice. Fly brings home a run. So Brady Robinson scores for the third time.
Now batting for the Ravens, the third baseman, number 17, Camden McKernan.
We're still not out of this yet because there's a runner on third base. He's still in that scoring position. It's two outs. The Northwest is manufacturing runs, that's what you say. They're not getting them in bunches, but they're manufacturing runs and keeping this lead.
What you were wanting in the last frame, half of the frame where we had runners on a scoring position, one out, unable to get the runner home. The batter dug in deep at 0-2 and fouled off quite a few pitches, got it to 2-2, but tricked him up high and he swung and out high and outside.
Yeah, same scenario.
That's a strike.
Same scenario. We had runners on the corner, stole second base, had runners at second and third, and fouled off a bunch of pitches, and eventually struck out. So, same scenario for Olathe Northwest. You know, make a decision. You're up two, so you don't want to run you don't want to run this guy into an out. So you want to be selective on when you want to send him. trying to keep him close now. And sometimes in this situation, you don't want to throw too many balls over there. We should rid him the home plate.
One and one is the count.
The fans in the background getting a little excited. Low and outside. Low and outside. I got it.
One and two is the count for Camden McCormick.
Pit corner. Do your job. Looking good.
Ball is low. A little low and outside. We've had this steady stream of sprinkles.
Yes.
It's just enough to annoy you, to annoy your glasses, Coach.
Just
my
enough.
Glasses are filling the drops.
Yeah.
There it is.
Ooh. I wanted that one.
Yes, wow. I'm with you on that. I wanted that pitch as well. Man behind the plate said it was a little up and out.
Full count. Dumont has a chance to.
Got him. Overthrow.
So stolen base. Stolen base, double steal, run scores.
Yeah, it's quite unfortunate that was a picked that runner off. Was going. That was the only time that he was actually going in an entire pitch count and picked him off and it's an errant throw. A little too high for the shortstop coming across to make that tag. So run scores. Now you're down three. It's getting late in the game. You're gonna have to get an out of here and you're gonna have to. He's bat swinging in that next inning and get some runs.
Mitchell's throw was too high.
I got it.
Another foul pitch, full count still, 3-2.
In my younger days, we didn't have a fence this high.
No, we didn't.
That ball would have been over here, and I'd have had to make a play on it.
It has the netting even at the top, so
yeah,
that helps out.
Yeah.
I see a ball up there that's caught in the net.
Yeah, it happens. Sometimes those are up there intentionally.
And that's just another walk.
So
bases are loaded again.
Well,
not quite loaded. I'm sorry. Runners on first and second.
Now batting for Lake Northwest.
He's consistent.
The designated hitter, number seven, Will Mundy.
He's not giving anyone that pitch.
So number seven, Will Mundy. Mundy.
Hey, we'll get the same zone. Don't worry about it.
That's a nice hit in play, and that's out, third out. But after four and a half, score is 5-2. We're going to look at the standings. The regional standings, we have Gardner-Edgerton High School. They're at the top, even though the record is not correct. We have them at the top in our regional, followed by Blue Valley High School, 17-2. Olathe West, and several other schools there. So we will host a regional here at this stadium, regardless of the outcome of this particular contest. We still have some plays to go. We still have three half innings to go for us.
We do.
To catch up for that three-run deficit.
We need to wake these bats up and get some runs and get some excitement generated on our side and get our fans up and moving around. So, you know, they look to be, we're on the visiting side, so our side looks to be a little quiet right now.
Yes.
We need to some hits in.
And we've got the trivia question for a generation of young men and women in USD 231. Their first memory of interscholastic athletes. Athletics involved this 2005 GEHS Hall of Fame inductee. He coached for 29 years at the junior high and had been associated with GEHS athletics for 57 years upon his retirement. He taught math and retired in 1999. That is your hint. Can you figure that out?
1999.
That ball's foul. Carpet didn't slow that up that time.
It did not. It had that spin on it, and it just kind of slowly spun away, and the catcher made sure that it was not fair.
Veered off to the left.
It's a good bunt, though. He would have been safe, that's for sure. It would have been a tough throw. So the ball was rolling towards the line, and you guys might have seen that. And as soon as it crossed over that line out to foul play, the catcher just smacks it away. You see that every so often, man. They just smack it away and say, yeah, I'm not picking that ball up. But if he touches that ball and it's on the line and he smacks it while it's on that line, then it's ball is interference and would have been on first base, but that ball was outside of that line, and he just knocked it away. Yeah, so we'll call that a fair live ball if he touches it when it's on that line.
2-2 is the count.
You have to be careful doing that, though. Swing too early. The ball is still touching that line somewhere. That's interference.
To bat is Jake McClure. He had a single in his last at bat.
Sure, I'd like to see him hit one now.
Be a great time. Start off the inning. Nice double.
Good eye.
Full count.
Game here, kid. Nothing free.
For high school kids there, we've seen some patience out of these kids today. There's been a lot of 3-2 counts today. So
looks like a one that's catchable. So shortstop comes over to catch it to record the first out.
Now batting for the Blazers, the shortstop, number 4, Hayden Dyer.
Shortstop Hayden Dyer. He has an official count with the walk and a fly out, 0-1 for this game, but third time up. One out. Recording this frame, right up to the third baseman. So out there. The Raven faithful, they are excited.
Now batting for Gardner Edgerton, the right fielder, number 2, Landon Turner.
You see that third baseman right there. I can tell you there's no greater feeling as a third baseman there. David, to go to your right, slide down, and kick that ball, come up, and fire it across that diamond for an out. Everybody's cheering, and inside you're saying, that's right, I got you. You don't show it too much, but I got you.
Yeah,
that's a nice another ball. Opportunity now. Fair ball. We just had that conversation. Didn't we? We just had that conversation. That ball died right on the line.
It died on the line.
Now, for the
that's a single.
The first baseman, number 21, Dawson Williams.
Dawson Williams is up to bat. He's 2-for-2.
Once again, that carpet does different things to that ball. That was dirt. Hit a little pebble and come back in, hit a little pebble, go out. That carpet just stopped it.
No pebbles. No,
no pebbles.
Pebbles. No pebbles.
Nope. Just
tire little, pebbles.
Just little rolled up tires.
So Dawson Williams is perfect so far. Had an RBI. He also scored.
Well, you know, a nice home run right now. We'll give him RBI, so we need.
Colton has a stolen base. They're going to give that to him. To Landon Turner.
Go, Colton. That's a three, kid.
See those rubber pellets fly up. Ball hit the ground. See it too much in baseball as you do in football. Those pellets do get in your eyes every so often.
2-0's account. Thought about it, but that one was low. And still have Colton, who's a reliever for the Ravens, on the hill. So far, he's managed to got the first two batters out this inning. Down in the count, 3-0. And that's a strike. Williams definitely has the ability to put it in play.
Mm-hmm.
We wanted to see what he was going to be presented with. 3-1 count.
He wanted to.
And that is a walk. Two out walk.
Now batting for the Blazers. The third baseman, number 16. Austin.
And Austin up to bat. Austin has slid out twice.
Twice to the left fielder. A little late on the swing. Getting under the ball. And it's, the fielder's just able to run up underneath some of those. I like to see him turn on one here.
He goes for that first pitch. That's a strike.
I'd like to see Austin get a nice level swing, base hit here.
Another pitch fouled out, so he's down in the count 0-2. They need runs.
To see him keep that back shoulder up a little bit. Oh, get up.
Go. And there we go. We get one run back on an error. So number two scores.
Get the batter here.
Take a look at that play right there. Catcher just kind of, ball just kind of sailed on him. I think if it was a good throw, he was out. But we scored a run, so that's what I'm happy about.
Ooh, thought about it. That was up high. Good eye.
Good spot.
2-2 is the count. Man still in scoring position. That's another one up high. So now it's a full count after being down 0-2. Now a full count, 3-2.
Battle back. Give yourself a shot. Anything close, you got to be swinging, though. You stand there and watch the third strike go by.
We'll love for a home run. Whoa. Didn't get the home run, but got it right there to first base. So that's out. All right, so that line out. So that's at the end of five. The score is 5-3. The good guys get one in this frame. We'll be back after this message. You're watching GEHS-TV, MSTC Sports.
Your whole team can see your upper thigh. Pour that smooth roast and aim that camera up high.
The best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup.
What is Coca-Cola? Is it an excuse to get together? Since 1886, Coca-Cola has been passing on smiles from generation to generation. We've been giving kids scholarships. Like the early birds and the all-nighters. And you get to enjoy what matters most. Coca-Cola. Drink up.
And we are back. We are back. So we have on the hill number 15, Garrett Bergman. Garrett Bergman has taken the hill now for our Trailblazers. It's a score of 5-3. We're starting the top frame of the sixth inning. It's a chilly night here in Kansas City.
It is Gardner, Edgerton. It is chilly.
Southwest side of Kansas City.
Yes, we're in southwest Kansas City. We're out a little ways. Nothing out here to block the wind. He just blows freely.
It is blowing freely, and this chain link fence is not a good. It's not blocking us very easily.
A lot of holes in this chain link fence, allowing the wind to come right through and hit us.
Up to bat is number 9, Stephen Mesa, the 8th man in the order. First pitch is a ball. As we mentioned, Garrett Bergman is the 3rd pitcher. Today taking over after Dylan Boutash. That's a strike there. Good pitch.
Good pitch, different pitcher, different arm angle. So batters have something to adjust to.
Another strike.
Oh, see
you,
kid.
So, Garrett, you're feeling good right now. 1-2. Shaking off the pitches. That's outside. 2-2 is the count. Is foul. Foul ball.
Called it just foul. Take a look at that replay if we got it and see. It's a little hard for us to see right here. But field umpire starting to learn, so if anybody knows where it's at, it's him.
And you see that just on the right side of first base.
Just on the right side. Just on the right side.
Started over. 2-2 is the count. And strike. He strikes him out. First batter is a strikeout. You have to feel good about yourself.
Now batting for Northwest, the second baseman, number 8, Sam Eric.
That's only the second strikeout of the game for the Ravens that they've.
The Blazers, yeah, that's
one. Blazers have struck them out twice. That's kind of a bunt. And they get him out. He's out.
Bang, bang.
Excellent defense there.
Bang, bang play right there. Take a look at it right
now. Now batting for the Ravens. The shortstop, number 21, Brady Robinson.
Make the pitcher play his position. Bunch will make him play.
Brady Robinson is at the top of the batting order. Shortstop, and that's a strike. Robinson is 3-for-3. He's had a single, a double, and a single. And he scored 3 times. So 3 of the 5 runs he scored. We hope to stop that streak.
He has been a menace today. He has caused us a lot of problems.
1-1 is the count. Just low. Two and two's the count. Or 2-1, I'm sorry. 3-1 now. 2 outs. Maybe he just wants to put him on base.
No, there's but no need to put him over there. We're down a few runs, so let's go ahead and get him out.
If he wanted to or not, that was a 5-pitch walk.
Now there's a runner out there, and that's going to give you more things to think about. That runner's going to be in your eyesight and
now batting for the Ravens.
Forcing you to pay attention to him. So.
Carson Reeves.
All fairness, Carson Reeves is 0-for-3. He had a strikeout of his first at bat. Pop out. So let's see if the streak will happen. We'll continue. And they record the 3rd out there. So excellent half frame. Get away with just a walk. All right, we're going to look at the trivia question one more time. For a generation of young men and women in USD 231, their first memory of interscholastic athletics involved this 2005 Gardner Edgerton High School Hall of Fame inductee. He coached for 29 years at the junior high and had been associated with GEHS athletics for 57 years upon his retirement. He taught math and retired in 1999. Who is this legend? Go to Facebook. /MSTC Sports / to enter the correct answer. I sure hope somebody gets on our watch.
Well, I hope so. Last time I was on the watch, they didn't get the answer. We had to give it to them. After a couple games, no doubt.
Well, I do want to let you know that, remember, we have graduation May the 22nd on GEHS-TV. Remember, 10 a.m. is the graduation, is the start of graduation. The confirmation will be at 8 a.m. on that day. If there's rain during that time, they'll move it back to noon. If it continues to rain, they'll look at two-hour increments of time. And then if that day is a rain out, then they'll go to the Sunday, May the 23rd on a Sunday, and we'll have the game. It will all be shown live right here. You're on the spot, GEHS-TV. So be sure to join in and be a part of that celebration. There's so many things that have had to be that have been done that are different than what we've done in years past, but I do applaud the Gardner School District, for what it's done to ensure that our fans, our parents, our families have been able to be a part of the sports that have gone on. We brought football to you, we brought soccer, we brought softball, baseball, basketball, wrestling. All of the sports have been brought to you this season. I may be leaving out a few. More, but we've been able to see even our freshmen, junior varsity sports. We've seen it all, and that's a commitment from the Gardner-Edgerton School District, and we appreciate that. Applaud the athletic department, athletic director, superintendent for allowing it to happen, board members, everyone involved.
Home run over the back fence.
No small feat to do this, to bring these broadcasts to you. But what's special is that we get a chance to see scholar athletes performing at the highest level, performing at their best, giving their all.
Some of them will play at the next level, and we'll say we saw them call their game. Some will play professional somewhere, and we can say, hey, we saw them play when they were
most importantly, young fellas. Most importantly, they're college and career ready.
Yes.
They are ready to take on what lies ahead of them. And I know that you and I, we both feel pretty good about the future.
Yep.
These young people have definitely been prepared to do the impossible. And we thank the parents. We thank the parents, the grandparents, those who have committed that time to these athletes, and of course the educators.
The educators,
the unsung heroes in our world, those teachers, those classroom teachers, those staff members who make it happen.
Yeah, we can't do this without you, Doc. You know, you're principal, and you know, you see these kids all the time, so
it's
I applaud you. I coach, but I'm not in the classroom. I'm outside. I can be as loud as I want to be outside.
Yes, you can. It's not a faint of heart. I can say that.
It is not.
You have to be prepared as practitioners to change and adjust, as teachers have done and staffs have done it, schools have done it. And we've done it with little notice.
Yeah.
Number 18.
Yeah. He hasn't been in scramble mode all this time. And my regular job is I can work from home, so I've been at home over a year now, working from home. We don't think we're gonna go back into the office until sometime in September. And it's what they're talking about right now. So we'll see. You know, we will definitely see if it works out. In my line of work, as an IT guy, if I had to, I'd have my laptop up right now and call a game with you and still have to be on, logged into a server doing some work if I was on call. So
multitasking, that's what it's taught us here.
You get used to it. Get used to it. These kids are going to be way better at it than we were.
Absolutely. Pitching for the Ravens is Luke Pavlovich. Luke Pavlovich, who is pitching. Up to bat is McMillan.
To use your head, catch
him. 1-1 is the count. McMillan had a single the last time, RBI, single and a stolen base. 2-1, he's ahead of the count. But, Coach, I also have to say coaching is not an easy thing to do either.
It's not.
It's a sacrifice that's made, time away from your family to go and help other young people realize their dreams.
Yes. A lot of after-hours work done that folks don't really know about. So.
I think you would say that sports definitely helps build character with our young people.
It teaches you different things. Each sport has a different discipline and, you know, teaches different things. But at the end of the day, it all. Let's take a look here. Good catch by the right fielder.
That was a fly out by number 18, McMillan.
Now batting for Garson. Two out. The second baseman, number 3. Carson.
Let's see if Shrek can redeem himself. He had a disappointing at-bat. You remember, he started down low. We had runners in scoring position.
Yes.
Second and third base with a one out and recorded the strikeout. So let's see if he can get them back with a different pitcher.
Right,
calls a timeout.
He got caught with the high cheese. He's out there. Threw that high cheese and he tried to nibble on it. It was too much.
What'd you call it? High cheese?
It's high cheese, man. It's, he fouled off several pitches and pitcher changed the eye level on him with that high cheese and two strikes. He was in survival mode. So
maybe he needed my taste buds. I don't eat cheese. I would have chased after the cheese. Now, if you said steak, that's something different.
Well, you know, some people don't eat cheese. Some people don't eat steak. So,
they sure don't.
I'm in a bad situation. I don't know what to say. Maybe I'll throw some candy out there.
Hey, there we go.
Everybody eats candy.
We all eat candy. There we go. 2-1 is the count. So this time he's ahead of the count.
Yeah, we're going to see him go ahead and get a nice little base hit here. Get on base.
And that one was brought to you by, once again, GEHS-TV, MSTC Sports, Surround Sound, Backstop.
Yeah, let's see. So we've had a pop. We've had a whack. Guess we'll get a slam on that one. Huh? Okay. At some point, we'll get them all in.
There we go.
Maybe we get Robin to run across the outfield.
There we go. There we go.
We just like to have fun to call the game.
Whoa, that's a nice hit.
Dig, 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 dig,
dig. But that one, they're going to get him before he gets there. So 1-2-3 inning. At the end of 6, the score is 5-3 in favor of the Olathe Northwest Ravens. We'll be right back. We're watching GEHS-TV, MSTC Sports.
My name is Ricky Gutierrez, and I'm from Eden Prairie, Minnesota. I'm an educational studies major, and I am hoping to go into school counseling. Earning a degree is important to me just because of the opportunities it opens for me for my future. I always knew I enjoyed working with kids, and that was something I was passionate about, and I originally planned to become a teacher. I realized I was more passionate about the kids and their upbringing and their development, and K-State actually offered a program that worked perfectly with my interests, and so I decided that school counseling was kind of the right path for me, just so that I could focus more on that psychology aspect and work with the kids on a more intimate level. Plans after graduation are kind of, they're exciting because I have plans to get my master's degree in counseling. Hopefully I'll have to do that. But also just that experience of getting some real life work in schools and specifically schools in Costa Rica. Half my family still lives out there and I would love to go spend time out there with them and just to get to experience that culture and that lifestyle and all the while still helping people and working with kids.
And we're back to the last frame of this competition. So we believe, yes, we're able to go into extra innings. Right now, the Trailblazers are trailing by 2 runs. The top of the 7th inning, number 13, Zach Brink is up to bat. His last time was a walk with a stolen base. Last inning, they were only able to put up 4 batters. And one of the best innings so far for the Trailblazers.
You know, there used to be a time that between innings, the umpire would wipe off the plate. He hasn't touched that plate yet.
No, it really hasn't.
I think my OCD is kicking in. I need that plate clean, man.
Well, actually, it's pretty dirty. It's up there,
driving me nuts.
Yeah, there are a lot of tire pebbles there on the home plate.
Yes, sir.
And four straight pitches. That's a walk. Up to pitch for us is number 32, Zach Sanford.
Now batting for Northwest. The catcher, number 34, Bryce Johnson.
So, leadoff runner. Fourth time through batting order. Bryce Johnson, the catcher, is up to bat. Bryce had a single his last at bat. Right up the middle. There we go. Right up second. Can they get two? Yeah, and it's a double
good
play.
Good turn.
Now batting for the Ravens. Number 18, Ethan Kemp.
Up to bat is number 18, Ethan Kemp. Ethan started out as pitcher, the original pitcher of the game. 1-0 is a count. Nice pitch. Center fielder is going out to make the play, and that's the end of the inning. Only three people come to the bat.
That was the fastest inning we've had. Let's get these bats going.
It's definitely the fastest. Well, hey, trivia question one more time. Trivia question. Somebody has to know this.
They don't have Facebook. That's what it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, generation of young men and women, USD Turk 231, the first memory of an interscholastic athletics involved is 2005 Gardner Edgerton High School Hall of Fame inductee. He coached for 29 years at the junior high and has been associated with GEHS Athletics for 57 years upon his retirement. That was So McNulty, who taught and retired in 1999. So McNulty.
You know, I knew that answer.
You knew that answer?
I knew that answer.
Wow.
I knew that. I've seen it before. I couldn't give it away.
Well, there you go. They never told me. They didn't tell me before the broadcast.
You know, if you would have asked me, I would have told you. You never did ask me, so I just let you keep reading.
Hey, man, I could have entered something in there and got the prize. So hopefully someone won.
There's a disclaimer. No employees are able to get that prize.
I mean, there you go. So 57 years.
Well, 57 years.
That's a long time.
Yeah, nobody around here now knows Soul.
That's a long time.
So. 1999, Prince said he's going to party like it's 1999.
Remember that song.
Boy.
And I thought, wow, that's a long time.
Yes, sir.
I'll be a grown-up.
I remember 1999.
Yeah.
Look at that Pizza Hut, man. IT.
It's the year I graduated college.
We had to all be in the office. Some had to be in the office that night. The rest of us had to be in the office 6 o'clock in the morning, because we knew what was going to happen at 2000.
Yeah, remember that? They thought everything was going to stop.
Yeah, we thought things were going to stop working, man.
People had trash barrels filled with water.
Yeah, they had a lot of things filled with water.
I'm not going to say who did
that. A lot of things filled with water.
My parents are no longer alive. I guess I can say it. There's nothing they can do right now. Hey,
well, they could blow that wind at you. I'm just saying.
Yeah, well, they could. They could. And so, they had trash barrels.
Mom and Dad, rest in peace.
Trash barrels filled with water. Doomsday. Everything was going to stop. Everything was going to close off.
That's what they thought. Those computers just rolled right on over to 2000 like it was nothing.
That's what they did. So Ty Wood, we're at the top of the batting order.
This is where we need to get some runs.
Ty Wood grounded out the last at bat.
I got it.
Now that one was just brought to you by Rufus, because that was ruthless.
That was Rufus right there.
Yeah. Rufus did that one. Yeah, I don't know who Rufus is, but he's pretty loud.
He's pretty loud, yeah.
Whoa. Oh. Just beyond.
We'll give that one a bop.
Boogie, that a bop?
Yeah, that's a bop.
That was a bop. Rufus Bop.
Rufus Bop. Remember Rufus R. Jones?
Oh, wow. Rufus R. Jones. He loved barbecue, too.
He did love barbecue.
Barbecue ribs.
Yep, he Kansas loved the barbecue ribs.
Memorial Hall.
Yes, sir. Him and his counterpart, Bulldog Bob Brown.
Bulldog Bob Brown.
A lot of people don't know Andre the Giant
Brutus
started here.
Brutus the Barber Beefcake. You remember
Brutus
him?
Brutus the Barber, yes. And the Sheik.
Absolutely.
Remember the Sheik.
3-2 is a count, full count.
Let's get a hood here, Ty.
Oh, that's a good walk. Six-pitch walk. Some of the Raven faithful are not happy.
Now batting for the Blazers. The left fielder, number 7.
That's what the Blazers are. Folks at home can hear it, but you can hear me on my headset.
That's right.
I'm starting to get a little excited.
Up to bat, number 7, Jake McClure. Hey, this is senior night.
It's senior night.
This is the last time the seniors are playing in regular season.
Yeah.
That's a strike. I just actually watched on, I believe, A&E. They showed Sunday a marathon of great wrestlers. And saw Roddy Piper.
Roddy.
Saw the story about him, Andre the Giant.
Yeah, he started here. The Sheik started here. Hacksaw Jim Duggan started here.
Roddy Piper said his first time, he was a baseball player, actually, and he was drafted by, I know he played for, or he tried out for St. Louis. He hurt his arm. That's what he came out with. And he hurt his arm. After he hurt his arm, his right arm, he learned how to throw with his left arm. And got very close to making the team. And they didn't bring him on. And so after that, he just said, hey, I don't want to think about baseball anymore. I want to go into wrestling. I believe his father was a wrestler.
Mm-hmm.
Or as they would say, wrestling.
Yeah, I never really said how it is.
Because my mom, who's an educator, would say it is wrestling.
It is wrestling. She would. I can see her at the kitchen table saying that.
That's right. That is right. Whoa, that's a lot of. And so. That's how the ball game ends. Wow. What a, you know what, a thriller. That was a thriller right there. You have to be proud of the boys, how they played. We're proud of the coaches, how they've coached. So that's the end of the ball game. The Latham Northwest Ravens win it 5-3. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back after a brief time out. You're watching GEHS-TV, MSTC Sports.
Oh, okay.
And welcome back to our post-game show. You see that our Trailblazers were unable to pull this one out, losing 5-3. But once again, it was a great game, a great opportunity there played. Remember, we got upcoming events. You have graduation on May the 22nd. You'll be able to catch it right here on GEHS-TV. This graduation is set to begin at 10 a.m. If there is inclement weather, we're going to have a confirmation on at 8 a.m. whether or not if the graduation is going to happen on that particular day. If it does rain at 10 a.m., they'll reschedule it for noon on the 22nd. If it's still raining at noon, they'll go in every two-hour increments until if it's too late, then they'll plan it for the next day on the 23rd for graduation. So just keep an eye and ear out on that. But, hey, you can catch live action right here on GEHS-TV. We're going to look at the standings. The standings are not completely updated, and the record may not be complete. But we are looking at possibly hosting a game in the postseason right here on Tuesday. So there is for baseball. And softball would have we're looking at softball team for our Trailblazers. Regionals will be held on a Wednesday. So we can look for that. Both successful teams, even though we lost today, this has been a successful regular season for Gardner-Edgerton. It's been fun to watch. I haven't been able to, this is my first baseball game that I had a chance to work. But we want to thank the various people who make this happen. Producer Todd Henderson, extraordinaire. Director Mikey Ramos. The EIC, Mr. Ronaldo Davis, as we call him. Dad, Uncle Ray, who works this. We have graphics and director Christian Henderson. Sound technician Daryl Ramsey. That's part of our crew. And then we have our camera crew, Dalen Brown, Dominique Henderson, Chris Alt, Sean Hipsch, Ronaldo Davis, Chuck Holmes, Devin Surreal. Commentators, Danae Jones, Chuck Holmes, Coach Larry Fennell, and myself, right. Dr. Jarius Jones. We've had a great pleasure of being able to commentate. We want to thank everyone for this year. We want to thank the Board of Education. We want to thank the superintendent for allowing this to happen. We want to thank the principal and the administrative staff, the athletic directors. We want to thank every coach who has participated, who's helped out in this endeavor. It could not happen without you. And parents, we must say, we cannot say it enough. Thank you so much for all that you have done. Thank you for all that you've done. Let me take off this hood because it was raining. So that way you can see that I do know how to get myself ready. If you're going to get another camera shot, and you got my bad side right there. But nevertheless, we thank you so much for making this happen. It's you that makes this happen every single day. As an educator who knows what the struggle is, as a parent who knows what the struggle is, we thank you for the sacrifices. Thank you for bringing this action for your parent to our patrons. Thank you for allowing our parents to be a part of the game, even when parents were not able to come to events. Thank you for making this happen. Scholar athletes, we're proud of you. Those of you that are graduating, we'll see you May 22nd for sure. We may see you in some of the other competitions. But hey, we want to say thank you, thank you, thank you for allowing us to have fun. Well, you hear the music. That's only one thing. That means that we've got to end this broadcast.
We got to turn it on.
Coach, thank you. Any parting words?
Doc, I love to say this has been a great season. It's not over yet. We'll be back out here with these young men and the young ladies next week. And we're looking for great things from the Blazers family.
All right.
Thanks for being out here.
Join us again. GEHS-TV MSTC Sports. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see you the next time. Take care. Be safe.